In this video, I will answer the question, is going solar worth it in Arizona? Stay tuned. I've been holding off on making this video because I wanted to have firm numbers to compare last year with this year to tell you guys if it was truly worth it for me to go solar. Little background on my situation. I live in a 2,700 square foot house in Queen Creek, Arizona. Myself, my wife, our daughter, two dogs, and one cat. Now, some people think 2,700 square feet is big, others think it's small. We also have a pool, which uses a ton of electricity because it has to run 8 hours a day. So here were my findings. We saw about a 30% savings during the winter months and 50% savings during the summer months. Now let me show you some actual numbers. Comparing March from last year to this year, we saw a 30.22% savings. Now let's look at April. Comparing last year to this year, we saw a 49.43% savings, so essentially 50%. And let's look at May. Here it's literally a 50% savings between last year when we didn't have solar and this year when we did. Now I need to note though that we did not pay outright for our solar system, okay? They're charging us $94 a month at 0.49% interest. That's half a percent interest for the next 20 years. So at the end of each year, we're just gonna be saving a tiny little bit. It's pretty much a wash. So we go back to the question. So Sam, was it worth it? Yes, let me explain. You can easily transfer the loan for the solar panels to a buyer if you decide to sell your house. Plus, having solar makes your house more attractive to potential buyers. However, I think it's a no-brainer for you to go and get solar if you intend on staying in your home long-term. This is our forever home. We have zero intentions of ever selling. We got our solar installed by Fusion Power. My main man over there is named Matt Tidwell, and he took really good care of me. It was a very smooth transition from the day we signed the contract till they actually turned it on. There was absolutely zero upfront costs. I know you'll see commercials that say it's free. Yeah, upfront they're not gonna charge you nothing, but you're still gonna pay ultimately for the system. I got a $9,000 tax credit last year, and I needed it because I was gonna owe the IRS some money. Now please note, every year, the amount of tax credit you'll get can vary, so you may wanna look into that before signing the dotted line. My solar system came with a 25-year warranty. It's made in Germany, so you know it's quality. Did I mention my wife is part German? Now here is the biggest reason why I decided to go solar. This is something not a lot of people talk about. We've all seen recently how inflation has made everything more expensive. In fact, last weekend, I filled both my cars with gas. It was $120. And no, I don't drive a monster truck. I have a Toyota Sienna and a RAV4. Once our solar system is paid off, it's free energy to use forever. Considering my wife and I should be retired in 20 years, that's when we're gonna need that cost savings the most. I see this as a wise investment since we would be paying that same money every month anyway to the electric company. Now the system I got is a hybrid, meaning there's no battery. Once the sun sets, power for the house automatically changes from the solar panels to SRP, who's our electric company. Years ago, SRP did not play well with the solar companies, so back then it was not financially worthwhile to make the switch to solar. But they have since changed their ways, and they actually have something called the E27 plan. They only charge 4.6 cents per kilowatt off peak. The only downside is that I should not run the dryer during their on-peak schedule. SRP's on-peak hours are 5 a.m. to 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. during the winter months, which are November through April, weekdays. And also from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. during the summer months, May through August. Now here's a fun fact, dryers use a ton of power. This is something I didn't know. That's why in a lot of foreign countries, you won't see dryers in people's houses. Instead, you'll see them drying stuff on clotheslines. At the end of the day, this was a business decision for me. What I kept going back to was that I was going to spend this money anyway. And it's kind of like renting versus owning a house. If you're renting, when you go to move out years later, all those payments you see un gots, you get nothing out of it. Whereas if you own the property and sold it, you could potentially walk away with a huge profit. Well, in this case, you could potentially be saving a huge amount of money when you need it most in retirement. Like I said before, Matt Tidwell is my main man over at Fusion Power. If you live in the Phoenix Valley, he's the guy you need to call to ask questions. Don't be asking me. I'm just the customer. Matt will take good care of you. He answered all my million questions, all right? Be sure to tell him your buddy Sam sent you. Till next time.